Rehearsals are going well. We're at the very last stage, which is the really tough part, because all of the elements have got to come together. So the lights, the costume, the acting, the orchestration of the instruments and the band, it all just has to lock into one place, and we've got to do that all this week. So it's exciting, but it's also, it's a big show, it's a big fun show with lots of music. So this week the priority for me is to get the music nailed down. The idea for the music comes from the plot, because the plot for The Incredible Book Eating Boy is really about getting smart. You know, what happens in a show and what a show is about are two different things. So in the show, what actually happens is Henry eats lots of books, gets smart, and then it all backfires. But what it's actually about is getting smart. And he doesn't really understand books at the start. And then the journey of Henry is at the end, he really learns how to read and enjoys books. So that's factored into the score. So the score has got to be something that always sounds a little bit, doesn't make sense to Henry when he's talking about books. But when something true is said, like when the teacher talks to him and says, no one isn't smart, then this, everything becomes clearer. So as he gets smarter and smarter and smarter, the world becomes clearer, and then that backfires. And then in the very final scene, I won't blow it by telling you what happens, but when he finally understands what to do, you just get a little D major chord, which is perfect harmony, and that's Henry's whole journey. So my job is, as a composer, not to focus on like a song, but to organize the time of the whole show. So I start from the minute the lights go up until the minute the lights go down, and I've got to organize the journey of a soundtrack, really. So I think in terms of time, whereas the designer and the director, they have to think about space and time. But me, it's just time. So I want really a lot of different unusual sounds. So I've got some weird instruments in the orchestra, and we have six people on stage playing music throughout, which is absolutely fantastic at Christmas. And it's all live, and it's a real coup for Belfast to have such a brilliant band playing on stage throughout the whole show. I'm really excited about children hearing and seeing live music being made on stage as they watch this story. You'll laugh the whole way through it, you'll cry in places, and you'll be dazzled. I think when you make a show, at the end of every day, you have to ask yourself, would I like to see that show? And I genuinely would like to see this show. And I will, 60 times.